you so much kay Coach Joy Lynn. So it's loud and clear and everybody can see my yung sharing ko, no? Yung aking presentation, so everybody can see it. So that's good, no? So we can go ahead. Thank you so much, Coach Joy Lynn, for confirming it. Okay, so without further ado po, no, let's start para hindi naman masayang yung ating time. And I know everyone is so busy. And kailangan po natin siyang umpisahan na. By the way, no, para hindi naman ako magmukhang strangers to everyone and most of you, hindi pa ako masyadong kilala or hindi pa ako kilala. My name is Christopher Salvador. I'm a licensed associate financial planner po. 4 years na rin po dito as a financial coach dito sa IMG. And I'm also an ex-OFW. Now we are staying here for good in the Philippines. Entrepreneur and investor. Yan. If you can see those icons here, no, you can also follow me from my Facebook page, TikTok, and YouTube. No, so you are welcome to see it and to visit it. So at least we will learn something from it. No, okay, so thank you so much to everyone. So now, no, I'm sure everyone invited by your friends, families, and friends, no? Talaga namang, bakit kaya ako kinukulit neto? Bakit kaya patuloy akong ini-invite ng mga kaibigan ko or nung kamag-anak ko dito sa IMG? Ano nga ba talaga ang nilalaman neto? Paano nga ba ako matutulungan neto? Okay, so later on, we'll find out kung ano nga ba yung malaking tulong na may bibigay sa atin ni IMG. But IMG stands for International Marketing Group. It is established in 2002 po, no? And it is one of the biggest and fastest growing financial services companies in the Philippines today. If you are asking for our office, ayan po, makikita ninyo sa picture and our address po, no? Yan, so definitely in every company, meron tayong mission. And so as to our IMG, we also have our mission to help create wealth for families. We want to make a difference for families. Siyempre, no? We want to help families know the new solutions that will help them cope with the increasing financial challenges in a constantly changing world. No, napaka-importante na alam natin yung mga solutions in order for us to overcome kung ano man yung mga struggles natin pagdating sa ating finances. At ang sabi rito, no family left behind, di ba? Napakaganda na habang inaayos mo yung finances mo, ganun din yung pamilya mo para sabay-sabay nagiging maayos tayong lahat, no? And of course, hindi lang sa family natin, we can also share the same blessings to our friends, no? To our colleagues, or the people around us, no? Yung mga nami-meet natin first time, or na-meet lang natin somewhere, no? We can also share the same opportunity and blessings to them. Okay? So, what about you? No? What's your situation right now? Sabi nga natin kanina, there are so many people are struggling about finances, no? Pero ikaw, ano nga ba ang sitwasyon mo ngayon? What's the situation of many families right now? Are you even thinking, aside from yourself, are you also thinking to other families? Na ano kaya ang sitwasyon nila? Especially kung mga kapatid natin, ano nga ba yung sitwasyon nila ngayon? Okay? So I have some questions here, no, na somehow you can answer it by using our chat box para at least we can participate, no? Para naman alive na alive tayo and I will also know that you are still awake. Okay, sa Pilipinas po, 7 pa lang po, 7:10, no? And with sa ibang country na nanonood ngayon, siguro na mas maaga pa. Tingnan natin, no? So I have some questions here, no, that you can just answer yes or no. Una sa lahat, do you have problem paying your bills? Ayan, lahat naman tayo mayroon dumarating na bill sa atin. But the question there is, namomroblema ba tayo sa pagbabayad? Ayan, tama, sabi ni Sir Harold. Yes po, meron daw. Yes, sabi ni Ma'am Judita. Yes, pero ang tanong po natin ngayon, no, most especially sa mga iba nating mga kasama ngayon nanonood, are they having problems paying bills? Are you burdened with debts and loan? No, parang somehow hindi ka na makatulog. It's because of this, no? Burden na burden ka na. Do you need to borrow money when emergency arises? No, especially as of now, there are so many unpredictable circumstances na pwedeng mangyari. No, ano kaya, meron ba tayong emergency funds na nagagamit para dyan? Do you work hard but still not enough income? Diba? Lahat naman, ginawa mo na. Nagtrabaho ka na. Nagsumikap ka ng husto pero still not enough yung income. Are your children growing up faster that you can provide for them? Diba? Sa panahon ngayon, you will not notice yung mga anak natin, no, naglalakihan na yan. Do you have difficulties in funding your aging parents' medical needs? Lalo na kung wala pang IMG before. They are not much prepared, no, pagdating sa kanilang finances. Are there times you argue with your spouses over finances? Ako, napakahirap naman ng ganito, no? Kung ang pag-aawayan rin lang naman ng mag-asawa is finances, napakahirap niyan. Kaya it's very important for us to manage it, no? Dapat alam natin yung dapat natin ginagawa. Are you dissatisfied with the level of success you have now? Bakit kaya? Parang hanggang ngayon, nagtatrabaho ka naman, you're doing your best, pero bakit hindi mo pa rin na-achieve yung level of success na hinahanap mo? Tried everything but still in difficult situation. Diba? Maraming ganyan eh, no? Ginawa ko ng lahat, ano pa bang kulang? Sabi nga, I did my best, but I guess my best wasn't good enough. O diba, kanta yun. Pero you want to know what to do. First, know the reasons why you are in that situation. Diba? Kailangan alam mo. Hindi ka naman mapupunta dyan sa isang sitwasyon na yan kung hindi dahil dun sa mga ginawa natin. So, dapat alamin natin. Okay? A fast-changing world. No, we are living in a fast-changing world. Sabi rito, a changing world requires changing solution. Tama, di ba? Sa panahon ngayon, ang dami nagbabago sa mundo. Di ba? Sistema man yan, technical man yan. We need to know the new solutions for changing world. A large number of Filipinos could face increasing financial challenges. Take a look at the changes in our financial culture. Di ba? Yan. So, the increasing financial challenges, some changes in our financial culture, unang-una sa lahat, the rule of money is changing. Tama? Today, traditionally, yung savings account natin nagpipil, it's because of the inflation. Diba? So, I'll give you an example, no? Savings interest. Kunwari, nag-save ka ng pera mo para dun sa 0.5% per year versus inflation. Kung ang inflation is 4%, eh, ibig sabihin, negative ka pa niya, diba? So, that is an average nung January to July to 2021, no? Medyo mataas yung inflation. Pero, somehow, tumaas pa nga ng 6% yan eh. Paano na lang, di ba? Ibig sabihin, negative 5.5 ka na nun, di ba? We want to help families learn and have access to investment instruments that can outpace inflation. Later on, you will know kung ano nga ba yung mga investment instruments na yan. Pero dito, no, if you will imagine, no, if you could just remember that time before na sabi ng mga lolo at lola natin, mag-impok tayo sa banko. Diba? That it's simply because during those times, no, let's say for example, no 1984, if we are going to put our money in the bank, we could have at least 20% na interest rate annually. Diba? Pero it doesn't happen now anymore. No? Hindi na ngayon nangyayari yan. Kasi kung tutuusin, kagaya nga na sinabi ko, diba, 2021, ang savings interest na lang natin ngayon is nasa 0.5%. No? Medyo mababang-mababa or hindi lang medyo, talagang mababang-mababa. So we really have to know what are those investment instruments para ma-outpace natin yung inflation na tinatawag na yan. Okay, number two, the need for financial education. Lack of financial information is one of the reasons why many people are financially struggling today. Okay, may trabaho naman. Di ba malaki naman ang sweldo pero nag-struggle pa rin pagdating sa finances. Baka may kulang yung financial education, no? Sabi rito, no, based on the survey, 53% lang daw ang financial quotient ng mga Pilipino averagely. Nakakulong po, hindi pa man lang umabot sa 75%, which is yun ang passing grade, di ba? Passing grade natin is 75, di ba, sa school. Pero could you imagine 53%? Diba? So napaka-importante na dapat matutunan natin ang pag-aaral ng financial education. Number three, people live longer today. No? Wow, it's praise God. It's a blessing for us na yung life expectancy natin medyo mataas. No? Yung age natin umahaba. Well, that is a good news to all of us. No? Pero sabi rito, present and future generation are expected to live into their 90s. We need to have lots of money or else we'll live a long retirement life of financial distress. Diba, humaba nga ang buhay mo pero hindi ka naman nakapaghanda financially. What will happen to you? After your retirement, dumating yung health crisis sa'yo, saan ka tatakbo? Dahil hindi ka naghanda, sabi mo, aasa ka na lang dito sa PhilHealth, Pag-ibig, sa SSS, at kung ano-ano pa mga government entities na feeling mo pwede ka matulungan. Yes, somehow they will help you, but definitely, it will not be enough. Right? So, dapat paghandaan po natin yung ating pagtanda. Kung mahaba man ang buhay natin, then we have to be prepared for it. Skyrocketing cost of living. We work hard to increase our income fast, but prices of commodities increase faster. Totoo yan, di ba? Magugulat ka na nga lang, di ba? Kung may 1,000 pesos ka, pag pinambili mo yan, konti lang yung laman ng basket mo, pero ubos na yung 1,000 pesos mo. Many people have difficulty in providing the needs of their family, and cannot save enough money for their future kasi kulang. Diba? So ayan po, dahil binibigti at pinapatay tayo ng inflation na yan. Diba? Yung purchasing power of money, no, bumababa ng bumababa. Right? Pero somehow yung sweldo ba tumataas ba? Nagkakaroon ba ng savings? No. No? Most of the time, nababaon sa utang. Yan, no? Diba? Kubang-kuba ka na nakababayad ng utang mo, parang hindi ka na matapos-tapos ng kababayad. Okay, number 5, debt trap. Okay, we are in an era of easy access to money through easy loans, credit cards, etc. Totoo yan, no? Lalo na sa abroad. Nako, ikaw pa ang hahabulin ng mga credit card or ng mga banko na yan to have credit cards. Minsan tawag ng tawag yan, araw-araw tatawagan ka at pipilitin ka talaga nila na magkaroon yan. Diba? Without even knowing na natatrap na pala yung iba kasi syempre kakagat naman, diba? Many people may have to work beyond 65 years of age to survive. So ayan po, no? No money down, low monthly payment, easy installment plan, yan yung mga promises nila. Pero ang problema, pagbayaran na, hirap ka na. Nababaon ka na. Uncertain labor market. Manufacturing and BPO jobs are moving overseas to cut costs. And that is very true. In business environment, the whole world becomes your marketplace, but at the same time, your competitor. No? Number 7, so many temptations to spend. Dati yung mga bata, lumabas lang yan, dala chinelas, dala kung anong mga simpleng bagay, pwede na maglaro. Tama? Pero ngayon, kailangan mo pang gumastos. Diba, magkano ba ang presyo ng isang tablet? Diba, it will even cost you like 20,000 pesos para lang maging masaya yung bata. Bago mo ba yung, pag sinabi mong manahimik ka, mga bata kami, pag sinaway kami ng mga magulang namin, no, pag sinabi lang tumigil ka, titigil na ka nun yan. Pero ngayon, hindi na. Para tumigil yung bata, kailangan mo bigyan ng gadgets. Diba? Yun ang malungkot ngayon eh. Technological advancement, automation and powerful software continue to replace more workers. Yung tinatawag natin na ano na artificial intelligence, 'di ba? Dati pag bumili ka ng pupunta ka sa Jollibee para kumain. Kailangan mo pang pumunta doon kahit malayo pa sa iyo yung Jollibee, mamamasahe ka pa, pipila ka pa. Pero ngayon, isang click na lang o orderin mo na lang, darating na sa iyo pagkain. 'Di ba nare-replace yung mga tao? Right? So everything is changing around. In the past 20 years, many new industries are created and involved to provide solutions to a changing world. No, like for example, yung makinilya, yung typewriter, tama ba yung Tagalog? Yes, it's makinilya, right? Okay, dati yan ang gamit. Imagine mo pag nagkamali ka, palit ka ulit ng paper o kaya yung lalagyan mo ng ano, yung white ink, di ba? So hindi na siya masyado maganda. Pero ngayon, pag nagkamali ka, backspace lang, bilit lang, okay na yan. Then print mo na, no? Using your laptops, no? Yung mga devices ngayon. Or before, yung film. Kung gusto mo yung pinakamaraming ano, shots, 36 shots, di ba? Pero you have to be careful, kailangan. Bago mo i-click yung camera, kailangan make sure maganda na yung ngiti mo. Kasi baka masayang yung film, di ba? Hindi kagaya ngayon, kahit anong position mo, pag hindi maganda, delete. Then kuha ulit, di ba? Yan ngayon ang ating mga gadgets. Before, if you want to send mail or magsulat ka sa mga family mo sa ibang bansa, kailangan mo pang sumulat, dadating sa kanila after a month bago nila mabasa, di ba? Pero ngayon, hindi na. Diba? In a split of second, marireceive na nga nila yan using our Gmail, Yahoo. Right? So, ganyan na nangyayari. Degree, good job, work hard, and save. Then they will call you well off. Mayaman, wow. Diba? Mapera. Pero ngayon, meron kang degree, meron kang magandang trabaho, and you work hard and you save. Pero bakit ganyan pa rin? Diba? Meron ka pa rin utang. Bigat na bigat ka pa rin sa mga utang. Ano ang problema? Okay. So everything is changing around except our financial strategies. So we have to find something, no? Or financial strategies that we can just go out from this kind of situation. Before, one source of income was enough, pero hindi na ngayon. Tama? Before, ang OFWs are sure na maging mayaman. Di ba nakakapagtayo ng bahay, pag-uwi may pera. Pero ngayon, hindi na sure. May umuwi, mas marami pang utang. Right? Before, a parent could raise 12 children. O diba? Kagaya namin, no? Ang dami namin sa pamilya, 11 kami actually. Eh. Diba? So, my papa ko lang ang nagtatrabaho by that time. But they were able to raise us. No? Pero ngayon, isang anak na nga lang, hirap na hirap pa. Diba? Dalawa na nagtatrabaho nun, ha? ang both parents are working pero isang anak lang, ang hirap na. Many of the financial solutions passed to us by our elders are not applicable today, and that is very true. So kaya hindi natin masisisi yung ating mga bagulang or mga lola natin kung bakit they are not financially prepared. No? Another big change and big challenge in our world today is the pandemic. Diba? Ito, sabi ko nga, napaka-unpredictable na mga nangyayari ngayon. Sometimes lockdown, sometimes hindi. Sometimes lalabas mataas ang case, sometimes hindi. Diba? Pero ang tanong, are you coping? Nakaka-survive ba tayo dyan sa mga yan? So, we have our new solution. We are living in the most challenging era. We could face a more challenging future. People are more confused today than ever. So, they don't know how and where to begin. So, you are blessed enough kasi nandito kayo ngayon and you will know how to do it and where are you going to start it. Okay? Many more are expected to be trapped in endless cycle of financial frustration. If we stick with the old solutions and don't shift our paradigms fast enough and quickly learn financial solutions, we are likely to put our future and that of our loved ones in great jeopardy. Diba? Wag po natin hintayin na mapunta pa sa hindi maganda ang ating family. It's because we don't want to change or to shift, no, for the new solutions na meron tayo. Kasi ano man solutions, financial solutions na meron sila before, it won't be applicable for today now. No? Kailangan nag-a-upgrade tayo ng nag-a-upgrade. Yung mga technology nga nag-a-upgrade din, eh, di ba? Even your lifestyle nag-a-upgrade. How much more ang ating financial solutions? So we need it, no, ang bagong solution. So IMG core purpose, ano nga ba yan? We have to end national poverty. O di ba, napakasarap pakinggan ang IMG. They have that concern to other people to end that poverty. No, hindi man sa atin or hindi man sa family mo, but to other people, we can help them out as well, right? How we do it? Yan. End financial illiteracy. Marami sa atin mga kababayan kasi na pagdating sa financial literacy, parang allergic eh. Ano ba yan? Pangmayaman lang yan. No. Para sa ating lahat po ito, mayaman ka man or mahirap, you have the right to become financially literate and to become wealthy as well, no? Make business solutions be available to everyone. So that's what we do. That's our purpose. So the IMG complete solutions in one platform. So you'll find out what is this triple E. Ano nga ba to? So definitely it will help us, no? Yan. So number one, the first E is education. We provide the right knowledge and strategy. Okay, so dito sa atin sa IMG, hindi lang tayo basta-basta invest, basta tayo mag-save, or kung anong gagawin natin. We provide the right knowledge and strategy, the right information. We have to be knowledgeable in everything we do. Sa trabaho natin, dapat knowledgeable para mag-succeed tayo. And so, to our finances as well. Kaya education is very important. We do massive financial literacy campaign. No, we need to know how to cope with increasing financial challenges in a constantly changing world, no? Right information equals the right decision or choice, equals right action, equals right direction, and equals to what? Success, no? And the second E is execution. Hindi lang puro tayo aral-aral, puro education, but of course we have to take action. We have to do execution for what we are learning. We provide a platform to execute the knowledge in one-stop shop platform. Diba? So later on, makikita nyo ano nga ba yung one-stop shop platform ni IMG na meron tayo. Kasi we establish strategic alliance with many of the largest and respected companies in the financial industries dito po sa Pilipinas. No? Even the financial products and solutions, no? They are giving us the access and to become your own money manager as well. So be part of an environment where people have the same goal. No? It's yung mga taong nakapaligid sa atin, malaki po ang factor niyan. If we will become successful or we will become failure, no? Kung ilalagay natin yung sarili natin to those people who have the same goal to have a better future, then definitely you will also have the same. Pero kung ang gusto mo bumagsak, mag-fail, 'di ba? Then if you are surrounded by people na spender, gastos dito, gastos doon, 'di ba? Definitely you will not have a better future. So, piliin din po natin yung mga tao na yan. Okay? Then, the last one is entrepreneurship. Okay? We provide a business opportunity to help you increase your income. No? What's the good thing here is it's easy setup, easy startup. Wala pong territorial boundaries, no? If you can see from here, no, talagang in every part of the world meron tayong nanonood ngayon, 'di ba? So sa dami ng mga ating nanonood for tonight or for today, iba't ibang bansa po 'yan, hindi lang sa Pilipinas, hindi lang sa Dubai, sa Kuwait, but everywhere. So what does it mean? Wala tayong territorial boundaries. Okay, it's not limited. Wala rin pong malaking capital na requirements. No, kung magtatayo ka ng isang business, how much will you need to prepare? It even a million, no, para makapag-start ka ng isang business. No, pero dito, no big capital requirements, risk free. You can do business at the comfort of your home while taking care of your children. Diba, you still have time for your family. You work at your own pace, of course, on your own time. It is even flexible, wala po tayong quota, at there is no demotion on it, no? Our business is to make money, okay? And of course, we are not just making money, we have to save money as well. No, as we save, dapat it is also growing. And as the money grows, dapat protektado po 'yan, no? At dapat po natin 'yan ma-preserve. Bakit? Siyempre baka mamaya 'yan hindi makinabang yung mga tao mahal natin sa buhay sa lahat ng pinaghirapan natin. So business with benefits, you can even enjoy at least 62 exciting benefits for those IMG members and counting po. When I started here in IMG, it was only 18 benefits, that was 2017. Could you imagine 62 na? 62 benefits and counting more. O, diba? So sumabay na kayo dyan, sayang, diba? Ayan po, no, kung nakikita niyo yung mga tao dito, no, mukha po sila mga damo kasi green, no, pero they are wearing the most yung ating green jackets, no. Ayan, no, yung prestigious jackets na meron tayo dito sa IMG, no. Those who are wearing green jackets here are those people who have helped a lot of people. Yan, meron po tayong campaign before na 1 million financially educated families by the year 2020. It was taken in Petronas Tower in Kuala Lumpur. Tama ba? It's 2016. Okay? Yan. Using with this material also, no? Talagang we were able to accomplish noong 2019. What is our target? 2020. But we are already achieved it in 2019. Wow! Di ba? Napakaganda nun. Kaya syempre, di ba, na-challenge naman tayo. Anong ginawa natin? From 1 million, we level up, no, to 30 million Filipino people to become financially educated by the year 2030. Ang tanong, kaya ba natin? Of course. Kayo ngayon nanonood, congratulations kasi you are already part of it. How much more if you're going to share it to others? Diba? Yan po ang gawin natin. We have to commit ourselves in delivering these missions to everyone. It is a financial wake-up call to everyone. Sabi nga, no family left behind, di ba? O, yun ang importante dyan. We have to carry the mission with passion, with love, no, to other people as well. Huwag nating sarilinin itong opportunity na to. Okay? Financial. Imagine building a house using a wrong plan. Yan, okay? So the right financial strategy. We have the financial strategy that is adaptable to a constantly changing world. Tama. Meron po tayong tinatawag na X-curve concept dyan. Yun po yung law of building wealth and the law of decreasing responsibilities. But of course, we're not going to discuss it right now. No? Meron po tayong separate training or sessions to that. So what we will discuss is about the building a solid financial foundation. So napakaganda na ito. This is the very core of what we are doing as well, no? Dito sa IMG. Okay? Importance of building a solid financial foundation. Ano nga bang ang importance nito? Can you tell if your house built on a strong foundation? Paano kung dumating ang typhoon, dumating ang earthquake, or any catastrophes, no? Especially dito sa Pilipinas, ang dami. O recently lang, nabalitaan ko sa Dubai or sa UAE, nagkaroon ng lindol. Which is very unusual, di ba? Pero somehow, in every part of the world, meron talagang dumarating na mga catastrophes. Ngayon, kapag dumating yan, yung bahay mo ba ay strong in foundation? And so, as to our finances as well, dapat po solid yung tinatawag niyang foundation. No? Pag dumating yung financial crisis sa atin, nawalan tayo ng income, nagkaroon ng sakit at disability, dapat it will stand firm. Okay, so I hope everyone can is learning, no, about what we are discussing right now. Okay, so we have to build a solid financial foundation for your family. Bakit napaka-importante yan? No? Kung napapansin niyo, para siyang isang hagdanan, di ba? So unang-una dyan, we have to increase our cash flow. We have to have healthcare, life insurance. Dapat ma-manage natin yung utang natin, magkaroon ng emergency fund. And of course, the last one would be the investment. Kumbaga, it is the very roof of our solid financial foundation ang ating investment. Pero bago natin pong gawin yan, there are some underlying components that we have to build first bago natin gawin yan, para masabi talaga natin strong ang ating solid financial foundation. Tama ba? So I hope everyone will agree to that. You can type yes, yes, yes or thumbs up po kung agree tayo dyan. Okay? So yan po, bakit ba kailangan natin gawin to? Because it is adaptable to a changing world, no? It is a weatherproof, pandemic proof. If you can see, if you will notice, no? Yan, thank you kay Ma'am Beth, no? Yan, yes, 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 sabi niya ganun. It is also a pandemic proof, no? It is all already proven, no? Most of our IMG members, no, mga umuwi sa Pilipinas, they were not worrying, no? Kasi bakit? Because they were able to build their solid financial foundation before coming back here in the Philippines. Thank you to those type yes there. Thank you so much. Yan, recession proof, earthquake proof, crisis proof, no? Ngayon talagang we are facing crisis, pero dapat we stand firm, no? Build strong financial future and we become wealthy and you will stay wealthy. Okay, so napaka-importante niyan. Okay, so never allow your family to live in a house with weak foundation. Siyempre kahit sino naman, di ba? Ayoko naman tumira sa ganun. Kunting yanig lang eh, nalaglag na. Baka madali tayo machuchugi dyan. So, ganun din sa finances natin. Pag hindi yan solid financial foundation, madaling machugi. Machugi yung financial house, okay? How to build a solid financial foundation? Paano nga ba natin i-build yan? Hindi ko naman sinabing gawin yung sabay-sabay, lalo na kung hindi ka naman able gawin lahat yan ng sabay-sabay. Kaya nga para siyang ladder eh, no? Sa ladder or sa stair, sa isang hagdanan, bago ka makapunta dun sa pinakamataas na baitang, of course, you have to take the first step first. Ano yon? Increase mo yung cash flow mo, di ba? Tapos, saka mo gawin yung healthcare, protection, life insurance, mag-manage ka ng debt, emergency fund, and investment. Like building a house, sabi nga, you have to build it from ground going up. Di ba? So, syempre, wala ka naman sigurong nakitang bahay na itinayo na nauna ang bubong. Lagi pong nauuna dyan ang siyempre, yung foundation. Okay? So, I hope everyone can follow, no? So, let's talk about the increased cash flow. Okay? How we will be able to increase our cash flow, no? Increase natin yung income natin. Find some ways, no? Kung ano pa yung pwede nating idagdag. Ang mga Pilipino, likas na masipag, likas na matyaga, likas na madiskarte yan sa buhay. Kahit ano nga, papasukin niya mga yan eh. Basta sa maganda lang pong paraan, okay? So let's increase our cash flow. Huwag tayo mag-depend kung ano lang meron tayo ngayon. And of course, dapat sinasabayan din natin yan ng reduce expenses, no? Baka mamaya niya, nag-increase ka nga ng income mo, pero nag-increase din yung expenses mo, no? Mas maganda, habang ini-increase mo yung income mo, binabawasan mo naman yung expenses. Okay? I hope everyone can follow, no? So, how many sources of income do you have? How many people rely on that income? Diba? Do you love them? If you rely on your present income and savings capability, where can you see yourself 5 to 10 years from now? Yan, hindi ko natatanungin kung magkano ang sweldo nyo ngayon, kung meron po ba kayo naiipon out of all the salaries na meron kayo, di ba? Pero try to see yourself after 5 to 10 years. Kung ganun pa rin kayo, kung kulang na kulang. Can you build a solid financial foundation? Kaya ba? With the income na meron ka, what would be your future and retirement look like? Sige nga, try to imagine. I'll give you 1 second. Okay. Try to imagine yourself when you are retired already, then you were not able to prepare. Make a lot of money, save a lot of money. Of course, we have to invest a lot of money as fast as we can. While you can. Napaka-importante po niya, no? While you can. Kasi baka mamaya yan, tsaka mo lang maisip kapag hindi mo na kaya, di ba? If you solve this, easy to solve all others, no? Hindi ko sinasabi na pera ang pinaka-importante sa lahat. dito sa mundo. Of course not, di ba? Pero napaka-importante rin yan para mabuhay tayo dito at sa mga pangangailangan natin, di ba? Yan, okay? So, increase cash flow, no? Pag nag-increase tayo ng cash flow, no? What will happen? We will be able to have our healthcare, to have our insurance, and we will be able to pay our debt, to have emergency fund, and of course, to build our investment. So, all we have to do is to do it and build it right. Huwag po natin yung pagrarambulin, no? Kasi may mga may marami po sa atin or most of the time na ini-invite natin dito para manood, narinig nila yung the word investment. 'Di ba? Oh, investment yan, sige, go tayo diyan. 'Di ba? Pero ngayon nalaman mo na na meron ka pa palang dapat na inuuna bago 'yan. Kung kaya mo lahat, then you can go ahead. So, increase cash flow. If you know you cannot be wealthy with your present job or business, but you want to be wealthy, then of course you have to use your spare time. Tama ba? Kailangan gamitin mo yung spare time mo. Yan ang pwede magpayaman sa iyo, hindi yung company kung nasaan ka ngayon. Do you love your job? Do you love the pay? Okay, question yan, ha? Oh, may mga kakilala kasi tayo na napipilitan na lang sila sa trabaho nila. Right? Work time, create wealth for your company. Hindi ko naman sinabing nakawin niyo yung oras nila. Do your best dyan sa mga kumpanyang pinagtatrabaho nyo kasi kailangan pa rin natin yan, no? But, after work time, create wealth for your family. Use your spare time. Hindi yung panayang overtime mo and sino ang yumayaman? Sila lang. Lalo na kung free pa yung OT mo, di ba? Thank you girl ka na lang, di ba? Parang sa charity na lang yung overtime, di ba? Use it for your family, no, to create wealth. So what do you do in your spare time? Busy making money, di ba? Or busy spending money? San ka ba dyan? You're the only one can answer. How many sources of income do you have? How many people rely on that income? Do you love them? Kaya ba yan? Kaya ba yung sustain lahat ng mga pangangailangan ng pamilya mo, yung income na meron ka? You can do IMG business during your spare time. Oh, di ba? It sounds good, di ba? Parang it sounds amazing. Ah, ang IMG pala, they also have business. Yes, you will find out later on. Okay, yun nga yung tinatawag natin kanina, entrepreneurship program. Okay, so next is, wait lang ha. Okay, so the less time you use to make money, the more time you can use to spend money. So you lose many times if you waste your time, you waste your money, and you master spending money, no? Increase expenses and increase your debt, no? Wala kang ginawa kundi maghanap ng pagkakagastusan at pagkakautangan. But the more time you use to make money, the less time you can use to spend money. You win many times, no? Of course, you make money and you save your money. You master growing money, no? You have to know how it works. And of course, increase income and build wealth. Okay? Pero ang problema ganito, ito is very, totoong scenario ito and totoong dialogue ito ng mga tao. I have no money. Wala akong pera. Diba? Ang question ngayon, ang tanong, may time ka ba? Oh. Kung yes ang sagot mo, din walang problema. So many wealthy people started with very little or no money. Wala kang pera, eh, di ba? Sino nga ba yung may nabasa ako, no? Sa isang apple lang na binigay sa kanya, binenta niya. Tapos hanggang sa dumating yung time na naging he was able to pay for 2 apples, then binenta niya ulit, di ba? Ganun, nagsimula siya hanggang sa naging may-ari na siya ng isang kumpanya. They just have enough discipline to use their time wisely. So, one thing that makes the poor equal to the rich is what? Time, no? Mahirap man o mayaman, ang time, pareho lang na meron tayo niyan. At pareho lang tayong may 24 hours a day. Wow, bongga naman siguro si rich man kung meron siyang 26 hours a day, di ba? Hindi naman fair, di ba? Pero lahat tayo, we have the same. Time is free, but your free time can make you rich. That's right. Time is priceless, time is gold, and of course, time is money. Time is free, but money can't buy time. Totoo yan, di ba? time is not refundable, hindi natin ang babalik, no? And we cannot even rewind that time. Yung tipong, naku, sana ginawa ko na yun pala kanina. Sana pala nag-save na pala ako kanina. You cannot go back in time, mga kapatid. Time give you value if you value your time. If you value your life, of course, you have to value your time. Kasi, kumbaga, umaandar yan eh. Lumalakad yan. Hindi yan pabalik, pero pasulong yan. Never waste time po, mga kapatid. O, ito pang tanong. Sasabihin sa atin ang problema. Wala po akong time. Ay, wow. Busy person, di ba? Busy person. So, sino ba yung makaka-relate dyan ng mga busy person? O, may nagtaas ng kamay. Ayan, busy pa kayo lahat. Ayan, okay. So, do you want to be wealthy? Eh, kung ang sagot mo, yes. Yan. Can you be wealthy if you have no time? Oh. Eh, lahat naman ang naging wealthy, hindi naman sila nag-sitting pretty lang. Hindi lang naman sila nagpahiga-higa at naghintay ng wealth, di ba? They do something. They spend their extra time or yung mga tinatawag nilang spare times, di ba? So, dapat ganun po tayo. Problem. Ito malupit. I have no money, but I have no time. Oh. Ano ba naman yan, mga kapatid? Ang daming excuses. Huwag po tayong ganyan. If we really want to become wealthy, then do something, right? So, one thing is to reduce your expenses. The surest way to increase your cash flow, yan, how? Yung budget natin. O, yan, kailangan, we know how to identify our needs and wants. Dito sa IMG, this is something that we have learned, no? Ito yung natutunan namin na ma-identify namin kung ano yung needs doon sa wants. Kasi bakit? Ang needs, things we must have in order to stay alive. Pero yung wants na yan, not necessarily na, lalo na sa panahon ngayon, di ba? Things we don't really need but would like to have. No, yung mga kapritsuhan lang natin. Meron ka nang cellphone, gusto mo pa may tablet ka pa, meron ka pang iPad, ang daming gadgets. Hindi, dalawa lang naman ang kamay mo. O, di ba? A budget is telling your money where to go instead of wondering where it went. Totoo 'yan. Kasi nakikita mo eh bakit kaya ang laki ng gastos ko this month? O, balikan mo yung iyong budget, yung mga nakasulat mo, yung breakdown. Ay, ito pala yun. Nakailang kahang sigarilyo pala ako ngayon nung last month. O, diba? Eh, save na lang natin yan. So, know how many percent spend on needs, wants, to get attention, to impress, or to be rich, or to look rich. Yan tayo eh, diba? Dapat, hindi lang sa panglabas na nakikita na mukha tayong rich. Pag malaki yung headset, hawak ay iPhone 15. 15 na ba? Hindi ko alam. Pero kung anong iPhone man yan, diba? Mukhang rich. Pero ang tanong, ang bulsa rich ba? Baka punong-puno pala ng utang. We buy things we don't need with money we don't have to impress people we don't like. Sad to say, it's very true. So one of the reason also we are in the wrong saving formula. Pagka-receive ng income natin, we have to less expenses immediately, no? Ang tanong, may savings bang natitira? Pagka-receive ng salary, saan napupunta yan? Big companies, right? No, diba? Bayad ng PLDT, Meralco, sa Globe, Smart, pasyal pa ng super malls, SM, di ba? O kain sa Jollibee and Starbucks, right? So normally dyan napupunta yung pera. Mayayaman ba yung mga company na yan? Yes. At sino nagpapayaman? Ikaw. Dahil pagka-receive mo ng salary, saan ang bagsak? Diyan. Ikaw ito, kubang-kubana. Ni hindi mo man lang binayaran yung sarili mo. Eh, samantalang ikaw ang nagkira. Okay? So yan. Walang savings. Okay? So this is some of the realities na pwedeng nangyari sa atin, no? If you've been working for 10 years already, how are you doing so far? Tapos kumikita ka ng 300,000 pesos average annual income, let's say. So, 10 times 300,000 pesos, ibig sabihin, you have earned about 3 million pesos. Ang question ko ngayon dyan, magkano ang savings out of 3 million? Meron ba? O sige, so kung may malakas ang loob po dyan na magsasabi na meron, then congratulations, diba? Congratulations. Pero kung wala, saan napunta? Resibo daw. Okay? So, it's not what you earn that counts, it's what you keep. Totoo yan. Whether malaki ang sweldo mo or maliit ang sweldo mo, magbabari po yan, magmamatter po yan kung ikaw ay nagsisave. Maliit ang sweldo, pero nagsisave, maganda ang future. Malaki ang sweldo, hindi nagsisave, puro gastos ang ginagawa pagdating ng panahon, nga nga. O, diba? Ang hirap nyo, nakanganga, nakatunganga, diba? Maghihintay ka na lang ng grasya. So, dapat po, paghandaan po natin yan. If you continue to do the same thing you're doing now, then where can you see yourself 5 to 10 years from now? Baka mamaya eh, di ba, mawalan ka pa ng trabaho, di ka pa nagpe-prepare, no? Ito yung tinatawag natin, no? Change, always do things better than before to get out of the rat cycle, rat race cycle na tinatawag natin. Okay, so syempre naman, no, from being poor, what we want for our families is to move them up to the luxury or ibig sabihin yung most comfortable life na meron sila. Diba? So, kailangan po natin yan. So, para magawa po natin yan, we have to do the better saving formula or we call it the prosperity formula. So, once we receive our income, that 100%, i-less po natin yung 10% and give it to our tithing, no? Regardless of your religion, your community, or the belief that you have, knowing that whatever we have right now, it is coming from the Lord. There's no question about it. Kaya, it's just right for us to give what is due to the Lord, no? The more you give, the more you will be blessed. And the 20% will go to your savings. Para naman para sa sarili mo yan, bayad mo sa sarili mo dahil ikaw ang nagpagod. Then, yung remaining 70%, you can use it for your expenses and of course, your lifestyle, no? If you are an IMG member, definitely, yung lifestyle na yan napapababa pa. Or even the expenses, right? So, malaki yung 70%. You can add some of this to your tithing or to your savings. Yan, okay? Financial failure formula. Wow, ano yan? Starting your financial plan when the problem is already there. Yan ang mga nangyayari sa mga ibang tao, lalo na pag hindi maalam sa pag-handle ng kanilang finances. Ito yung kanilang formula, no? Tsaka lang sila magkakaroon ng plano kapag nandyan na yung problema. Pag wala na pong trabaho sa abroad, napauwi na, or nag-retire na, o kaya biglang nagkasakit, tsaka lang nila marirealize, ano kaya ang gagawin ko ngayon? Right? Countless lesson, no? Even in the Bible also teaches us how to save. If you will remember, no, during the time of Joseph, no, yung binigyan ng dream yung Pharaoh ng Lord na that Joseph interpreted to him, no, na magkakaroon ng 7 years of abundance and magkakaroon din kasi ng 7 years of famine. What they did, no, they were able to save during the plenty time, no, yung plentiful time or yung abundance. They were able to save crops, no, by that time. Kaya anong nangyari? Egypt survived for the 7 years of famine. And hindi lang yon, even the other countries also were able to have the same blessings, no? Kaya napaka-importante po, even the Bible says we have to save, no? Kaya mag-save tayo. It was not raining when Noah built the ark. Diba? Ginawa ba ni Noah habang bumabagyo na? Hindi. Nagtataka nga siya, bakit? Bakit ako pinagagawa ng ark? E samantalang ang init-init ng panahon. Diba? Fix the roof while the sun shines. Huwag po natin hintayin ng bagyo. Plan for what is difficult while it is still easy. Sabi po ni Sun Chu. Again. So we can avoid the panic mode. Hindi yung pag nandiyan yung problema, aligaga ka na, hindi mo na alam kung anong gagawin. If you buy things you don't need, soon you will have to sell things you need. Wala nang matitira sa iyo. Ubus na yan. Okay? So do you know where your money is going? Do you know how and where you lose your money? Do you have an idea how much money you lose every day? Alam ba natin, namomonitor ba natin yan? Do you know the long-term impact of you if you continue to lose money? Yan, no? So sabi nito, we have to make a fortune from small change, no? Ano yan? From being spender, you have to be a saver, no? I'll give you some example of item na somehow we'll find out and we'll see na kung sinave pala natin yan, gano'ng kalaki yung pwede ko palang ma-save later on. Let's say sa soda, no? Kung ang soda ay 35 pesos per can or 35 pesos per liter, so ibig sabihin, no? Kung gagawin natin instead of drinking soda, which is magka-diabetes ka pa dyan, okay? Why don't we just save and use water? 2 pesos per liter ng water. So, kung 35 yung soda, hindi ka bumili ng soda at nag-water ka na lang, so ibig sabihin, meron kang at least 33 pesos. Kung sinisave mo yung 33 pesos na yan for 30 days na nag-water ka lang, then meron kang 1,000 pesos savings monthly. Kung ilalagay po natin yung pera na yan sa isang napakagandang investment vehicle wherein kumikita siya ng 10% at least na annual income, then it is in compounding interest after 35 years, how much would be that amount? 3 million pesos at least. remember, dahil lang po yan sa hindi mo pag-inom ng soda at nag-water ka pa at naging healthy ka pa. Eh kung pakain-kain ka pa sa labas, gagastos ka ng 1,000. Diba, let's say, for example, no, kung kumain ka na lang sa bahay, nagluto ka, alam mong maayos, alam mo pa kung anong gusto mong kainin, diba? Kung kumakain ka every week, sabi na natin nagda-dine out ka outside every week, no? Let's say, 4 times a month, okay? So, 1,000, kung nag-200 ka na lang, nag-dine home ka na lang, so may 800 ka na, na-save. So, times 4, 3,200 din yan na na-save mo for the whole month, diba? Saan mo kukunin yung 3,200 pesos? At kung nilagay mo yan sa isang napakagandang investment, you could have at least 10 million pesos. Ang laki, diba? Sa mga junk food, sweet snacks, no? Kung i-reduce natin yan, no? Magkaroon tayo ng 2 million. Yung bottled water, doon na lang tayo sa refilled water kasi napakamahal din yung bottled water, eh, no? So, ibig sabihin, we could be able to save at least 2 million pesos. Kung ito total po natin yan, that would be 17 million pesos. At least. Wow, ang laki. Siyempre, mapapaisip ka. Ilan na kung ikaw, hindi ka makakain kung walang soda. Walang soft drinks, di ba? So, either lang po yan, you gain because you save, or you lose because you spend. So, it's up to you. Kung isave mo yung 17 million na yan, or you spend it the whole life. Okay? So, di ba, napakaganda ng illustration, di ba, ng example natin. So, always remember po, no, from being spender, we have to be saver, no? Ayan. For items lang yan. So, we have to reevaluate all possible areas to find money to save. Poor man plans for the present. Yan, yung mga poor mindset, talaga naman, they always planning for the present only. Pero ang mga mayayaman, they always plan ahead for the future and for the generations to generations. So what are the areas to reevaluate to find money to save? Una, reduce natin yung mga sweets, junk food, soda, fancy coffee, snacks, liquor, etc. Yung mga vices na yan na hindi naman kailangan. Then put the amount on it. Save on parlor. Ayan. Yung mahilig magpaganda. Magpa-hair rebond, di ba? Sorry po dun sa mga rebonded ang hair dyan, no? Pero kung kulot na po tayo, lalo na maganda ka naman sa pagkakulot mo, hindi ko can go ahead, di ba? Medyo binigyan ko ng konting lambing para naman hindi siya masaktan. Okay? Pero syempre naman, di ba, isave na lang natin yan. No? Pa-relax-relax. Yun, ngayon, ang dami ko nakikita mga kabataan ngayon, mga color ng hair nila, paiba-iba. Every week, iba-iba. Imagine that. Less party, less gimmicks and gift, no? Lalo na ngayon, pandemic, no? Dapat limited yung mga social gatherings natin. Save on electricity, water, cable TV, etc. Lalo kung ikaw naman ay may pa-cable-cable ka pa dyan, meron ka pa ano, eh, lagi ka naman nasa ano mo, cellphone mo, doon ka naman din nanonood. Cut down on gadgets, phone, load, internet, etc. Avoid ATM fees, no? Yung bounce check. Kasi alam naman natin, nagkakaroon yan ng mga charges. Yung groceries natin, make a list para alam natin kung ano lang yung dapat nating bilhin. Pay off yung mga bad debts, no? Lalo na kung malalaki yung mga interest. Small change, big money. You can make a fortune from small change. Diba? Let's say for example, 10 pesos per day. More than 1 million po after 35 years yung pwede natin i-assume, no? Kung nakalagay po yan sa ROR na 10% per year. So kung 100 pesos naman yan per day ang gagawin mong pagsisave, then you could have at least 10 million pesos after 35 years kung i-assume natin na ang ROR niya is 10% per year. Okay? People who regularly save and invest can be wealthy. That's because of the habit we have. Sabi nga, money without financial intelligence is money soon gone. Sabi po yan ni Robert Kiyosaki. So use your cash flow to build a solid financial foundation. Okay, so yan, tapos na tayo sa cash flow. Let's move to our healthcare protection, no? Protect health and wealth, di ba? If healthcare is expensive, no? Mahal naman yan, magbabayad pa po yan every month or every year, then itry po natin ng wala. Pag ikaw ay nagkasakit, gano'ng kamahal? O yan, di ba? So what's the importance of healthcare? Kapag ikaw ay nagkasakit, lalo na kung wala kang pera at wala kang pang medication, saan ka pupulutin? Hospital cannot let you in without deposit, tama? So, sabi rito, a lot of sick people die not because or they become disabled, not because wala tayong medicine or treatment na available dito sa Pilipinas. Meron. Anong wala? Pera. Oh, walang healthcare. If you're sick without healthcare, your investment and your properties become healthcare. Kasi bakit? Kailangan mong ibenta yung properties, kailangan mong i-pull out ang investment para saan? Pangbayad mo sa iyong sakit. If not enough, then of course, you will get into heavy debt. Kulang yung pera mo eh. Eh, di dun ka sa utang. Diba? Kaya manghingi sa mga kung sino-sino. Medical cost doubles every 5 to 7 years po. Tandaan po natin. Kaya napaka-importante naghahanda po tayo. Okay? So, yan. Yan, gusto ba natin ng ganito? Yung comfortable tayo na kapag na-hospital tayo? Or gusto natin ng ganito? Natabi-tabi tayo sa hospital. Hindi ka na nga na-attendan ng mga nurses at ng mga doctors kasi ang dami yun na. Nalilito na sila sa iyo dyan. Maybe you can afford that what you want now. Lalo na kung nasa abroad ka, meron kang healthcare, no? Pero paano naman pagdating ng ikaw ay tumanda at wala ka na dyan sa mga kumpanya na yan? Make sure to get what you want or else you will end up getting what you don't want. Ang hirap naman yan. Ayoko dyan. So kung hindi ka maghahanda, then definitely you will go there. What is more important? Memorial or healthcare? Ayan. Many of us, many people, they prepared for the memorial. O diba? Punta kagad kay ano, San Pedro ba yun? Okay. Diba sa memorial? Without even realizing na, teka muna, bago ako mapunta sa huling hantungan, baka mapadaan muna ako kay St. Luke. O diba? Mapunta muna ako sa hospital. May pang-memorial ka na nga, pero wala ka naman pambayad sa healthcare. Anong gagawin mo ngayon? Di iniwanan mo pa ng utang yung pamilya mo. Okay? So why we need long-term healthcare, no? Employees, you cannot bring with you the health benefits provided by your company. Pag ikaw ay nag-retire at ikaw ang nag-resign, that's very true. Diba? OFWs, hindi mo rin madadala yung mga benefits mo pag bumalik ka na rito sa Pilipinas. No? Many healthcare companies don't accept applicants beyond age 60. Pag ikaw ba ay senior citizen at saka ka lang ngayon maghahanap ng iyong healthcare, naku po, napakahirap. At kung meron man, napakataas po ng presyo niyan. Most healthcare companies do not accept sickly applicants. I have experience and I have met people, no, na naghahanap ng healthcare. Ang tanong kagad, okay pa po ba siya? Eh may sakit na pala. You think basta-basta aprobahan niya ng mga healthcare companies? Definitely, no. Mababa ang percentage na yan. Super baba. When do people get sick? Young age or old age? Because they don't know about long-term care. So short-term care, yan. Pag sinaming short-term care, yearly renewable po yan. But renewal not guaranteed. If with high claims or mataas yung utilization, definitely baka hindi na yan ma-renew. Wala po rin siyang accumulation of unused health fund. Walang reward for being healthy. Hindi mo nagamit eh kasi healthy ka eh. Mababalik ba sa'yo? May end up without healthcare at old age. No? Kasi short term lang eh. Most people get sick at old age. Oo, bata ka pa, meron kang short term. Eh pag tumanda ka na, eh, paano na lang? So, ang solution dyan is to have long-term care, no? Ayan. It is guaranteed renewable, no? Meron tayong tinatawag na limited 7-year pay with 4-way life insurance coverage, no? Term life, meron siyang ADDD, waiver death, waiver disability. Health fund accumulates with interest 85% na ROP, no? If no claims, no? Yung pwedeng mabalik yung ano yung 85% of the total contract price, no? Reward for being healthy. Kasi di ba for 7 years healthy ka, hindi mo nagamit. So bigyan kanila ng reward and give you back the 85% of the total contract price. Ensure you having healthcare at old age. If don't get sick, money can be used for other needs. Hmm? Hindi naman tayo kukuha basta ng long-term care para dahil alam natin na magkasakit tayo eh. Good thing kung hindi. Pero what's the good thing there is, yung pera, magagamit pa natin for some other things. No, make sure to know more about Kaiser Long-Term Care. Meron po tayong mga trainings about it. Long-term care is a new solution evolved to help us cope with a constantly changing world. Ayan, tapos na tayo sa healthcare, no? Let's move to our life insurance. So we have to protect our family while building wealth. Ayan. You work hard because you love your family. family. Tama? Kasi you provide something for them. And you have big dreams for them. Hindi naman puro tayo lang na sarili natin. Lalo na kung may pamilya tayo. Gusto rin natin na magkaroon sila ng maganda at luxurious na pamumuhay. What will happen to your dreams for them if something will happen to you? Paano na yan kung hindi, di ba? Ayan, no? Ikaw yung nagbigay ng magandang ano ng buhay sa family mo kasi you work hard, no? Para mabigyan sila ng luxurious life. Pero, pag ano nangyari, kung ikaw naman ay nawala, what will happen to you? Di ba? Dapat meron tayong life insurance. Parang yan yung kalang, no? Ano ba tawag? Ano, I don't know the English, pero yan yung kalang. Yan yung magsisilbing harang. Harang, kalang, di ba? Para whatever happens to you, di ba, yung family mo, hindi sila babalik doon sa poverty. Di ba? Tuloy-tuloy pa rin sila kasi then you are able to protect them using your life insurance. Okay? You're so scared driving your car without insurance. Di ba? Ayaw mo, kailangan updated at dapat na-renew kagad ang insurance ng sasakyan. Kasi takot ka whatever happens to you. If your family is not protected with life insurance, are you scared also? Diba? Nakakalungkot minsan, diba? Ganyan ang problema. So, estimated cost of 1 million car insurance is 20,000 pesos per year. Pero, kung kukuha tayo ng life insurance for 1 million peso face amount, no, at the age of 35, that will cost you only 7,400 pesos a year. Pero, anong inuna mo yung sasakyan ka? O hindi mo man lang kinonsider yung para sa pamilya mo. You can save big money if you know how to buy life insurance. Know how insurance works and price because the cost of insurance is charged to you. No, dapat alam mo din yan. Buy life insurance based on what you need, not because you cannot say no to the one selling to you. Baka mamaya yan, kaibigan mo pala o best friend mo lang pala yung nag-o-offer. Kaya yes ka ng yes without even knowing kung ano nga ba yung pwede mong makuha. Know what life insurance best suits your needs, no? You can ask your the person na nag-invite sa inyo para at least ma-discuss about it. So term with PDF, buy term, invest, the difference, endowment, whole life, universal life, variable universal life, index life, yan, meron po tayong iba't ibang klaseng insurance. Have you heard about BTIB? Discover why this product is unpopular despite being superior product. Okay, yan po, no? Yung car insured, yung bahay insured, but the question there is, insured ba yung family? Okay? So if you want to insure yourself, like for example, no, you are at the age of 35, no, gusto mong insure yung sarili mo and protect your family, how much do you need to pay? 6,800 pesos lang po, no? Yan po yung tinatawag natin na most 18. Unbundled. Buy low price insurance and invest the difference in PDF. Meron po siyang saving feature sa mutual funds, stocks, markets, etc. Save on fees and charges din po yan. Makakalibre ka pa. Even the poor and average can properly protect their family. That's true. We just have to discover the best concept called buy term investment. Buy term invest the difference. Yan po yung BTID na tinatawag natin, no? In our training. Yan, meron po tayong mga trainings dyan, Real Foundation in Building Wealth, para mas maunawaan pa natin ang gusto. Okay? So, solve na yung life insurance. Let's move to eliminate debt. Pay off debt and eliminate the termite. No? Yan po yung magsisilbing anay sa ating financial house. Kung hindi po natin yan, tatanggalin. No? Debt is spending your future income today. So, debt and interest payments drastically reduce your take-home pay. So, your income or your salary, then deduct mo yung mga sa SSS mo, pag-ibig, yung mga kung ano-ano pa mga dinideduct sa atin o pagka-receive ng sweldo, especially dito sa Pilipinas. Then, take-home pay mo, yung natitira na lang para sa pamilya mo. Eh, meron ka pang interest na 5, kung ang interest ng utang is 5% per month, no? Normally, ganyan ang sinasabi, no? Mababa lang po ang interest dito, 5% lang po per month. No? Hindi ka na nag-calculate. Per year po yan, that would be 60%. Kung ikaw ay nag-low ng 50,000 pesos times 60%, ibig sabihin, 30,000 pesos po yan, interest pa lang yan. So without debt, yung 30,000 pesos na yan, kung nilagay mo yan sa isang investment vehicle na kumikita ng 10%, then after 35 years, you could have at least 10 million pesos. Diba? Sa credit card. Ang interest daw, 2% lang po, ma'am, sir, per month. O i-times mo yan sa 12 months eh. So 24% per year. O, di ba? Everything is changing around but the 5-6 remains, di ba? Equals 20% per month, 240% year po yan. Di ba? Laki. Also, 1% day, no? Sa 365% yan per year, no? Kung sinabi niya, 1% lang po ito a day, man. Okay, times 365 days tayo in a year, di ba? So, 365%, no? So, for 10,000 loan, interest niyan is equals to 100 pesos a day. I-times nyo na lang po yan. How can you increase your cash flow if you have so much debt? Totoo yan. Baka napupunta na lang sa utang lahat. If you cannot control your debt, of course, debt will control you. People in debt can be debt forever because of the habit. Many people live in an endless cycle of financial distress due to what debt. Ang dami natin kilala mga tao, no, na talagang napakalalaki ng mga utang. Yan, para makatulong sa atin, meron po tayo mga higher series of training how to overcome debt. Okay, so let's move to emergency fund, protect investment against put and take, also avoid debt. No, yan, no? Napakaganda kung meron tayong emergency fund, ma-avoid natin yung mga utang na yan. At mapoprotektahan natin yung ating investment. Right? So yan, emergency are unpredictable. Extended care for aging parents or in-laws, major repair due to accident, yung mga bahay, yung sasakyan, no? Mga catastrophes na nangyayari sa paligid natin, or even sudden loss of our income. Lalo na ngayong pandemic, marami ang nawala ng trabaho. Emergency. Ang tanong, pag ikaw ba ay nanganganak, is it an emergency? No. Could you imagine? Siyempre, bago pa lang mag-conceive, napagplanuhan na dapat yan. E kung nag-conceive ka, meron pa po tayong 9 months bago po i-deliver. Diba? Ibig sabihin na paghahandaan. College tuition fee. O bago ba mag-college ang anak natin, kinabukasan ba kagad college yan? Many years pa po ang dadaanan yan. Right? Or, ang gimmick ba? Emergency. Naku, meron po kami emergency lakad. O, di ba emergency? Emergency gastusan. Ayan, okay? Yung sale din, emergency daw yan. Okay? Charging your emergencies to debt will create more problems. So, what's the solution? Dapat magkaroon po tayo ng at least 6 times equivalent of our monthly income or monthly expenses, no? Para whatever happens to us, mawalan man ang trabaho, we can still sustain yung 6 months kasi napag-ipunan natin. Okay? So, solve natin emergency fund. Reach your financial goals. Knowing how to save is not enough, no? We have to know how to grow that savings, no? We have to know how money works. What if, no, you live too long? Who will take care of yourself? Yan. Sino nga ba? Siyempre, wala ka ng trabaho eh. Understand how money works, yung tinatawag natin na compound interest, and of course, how money market works, no? Through what? Yung ating mga mutual funds, stock markets, investment, effects of negative in investment, how money markets work, the best diversification strategy, active income, passive income, wealth formula, etc., etc. Okay, so build long-term investment, no? Take note po, ha, long-term investment. There's no such as short-term investment. No? Mamaya, scam na naman yan. Okay? So, when we invest, dapat we know how money works. If you know how money works, then you can make money work for you in the future. Know how to accumulate income-producing assets and create multiple passive income streams. No? The size of your passive income determines the level of your financial security. So, dapat po, huwag tayong sa walang bahala sa mga panahon ngayon, lalo na't meron pa tayong mga kinikita. Know how money market works, no? Know the investment instruments that can help you beat inflation and win the money game. So, di ba? So, dapat alam natin yan. Hindi yan pwedeng, ito daw yung makukuha kong interest rate every year. I-check mo muna kung mas mataas ba yan sa inflation, di ba? Para at least nabibit natin. Know how money works. Money works in compound interest. No? What is compound interest? Interest earning interest. No? Kumbaga, hindi lang yung principal na nag-interest. Kapag nag-accumulate na yan with the interest, yung total nun, it will also earn an interest. Okay? So that is actually formulated by Sir Albert Einstein, no? It is one of the 8 wonders of the world, no? And mankind's greatest invention because it is the mightiest force ever unleashed for the amassing of wealth. Diba? Yan, rule of 72. Ano nga ba yung rule of 72? 72 is a constant number. I-divide daw natin yung interest rate kung saan natin nilalagay yung pera natin, investment vehicle. From there, no, it will determine the number of years for your money to double. Para mas madali pa po natin maunawaan, I'll give you an example. Let's say, for example, nag-open ka ng account or savings account sa banko ng 10,000 pesos. Kung i-apply po natin yung rule of 72, 72 is a constant number, divide po natin yung 1, that would be 72. 72 years po bago mag-double yung pera mo. So your money doubles after 72 and it will become 20,000 pesos. After 72 years, nasaan ka na kaya niyan? O kung nandyan ka pa naman po, eh, ang tanong, magagamit mo pa rin ba yan 20,000 pesos na yan for your retirement or kapag tumanda ka? Hindi, di ba? Okay, let's say for example, meron ka, nilagay mo sa 2%. Okay, 72 divided by 2 is equals to 36. So every 36 years, magdodoble yung pera mo. Okay, yan. Doubles every 36 years. Kung 29 ka nag-start plus 36, di ba? Plus 36 years, 65 ka na. Yung 100,000 pesos mo became 200,000 pesos. Masaya ka na ba dyan? If ever. Pero syempre hindi, di ba? Yung 100,000 pesos mo na sinave, 200,000 pesos lang siya naging. 100,000 pesos lang ang kinita mo. O let's say for example, nilagay mo siya sa... ayaw niyan. Wait lang. Nag-ano yung atin. Yan. Okay. Let's say sabihin na natin sa 8%. Okay. 8%. 72 divided by 8 is equals to 9. So, ibig sabihin every 9 years, dumadoble yung pera mo. At the age of 29, you put your money in a savings account for 100,000 pesos. Then, plus 9, 38 ka na. Plus 9, 47 ka na. Plus 9, 56 ka na. And plus 9, 65 ka na. Your money became 1.6 million. Okay na ba yun sa'yo? Why not, di ba? Pero, paano pala? Kung sasabihin ko sa inyo na meron din palang investment vehicle kung saan pwede nating ilagay siya sa at least 12% interest rate. Could you imagine? 70 divided by 12 is equals to what? 6. Your money doubles every 6 years. Kung at the age of 29, naglagay ka ng 100,000 pesos, after 36 years, naging 65 ka na, your money grow to 6.4 million. Ang malungkot dyan kung nilagay mo lang sa 2%. Out of 6.4 million, nakuha mo lang 200,000 pesos. Where in fact, kumita pala yung pera mo na yan ng 6.4 million. So kanino na ngayon napunta ang 6.2 million? Well, kung saan mo nilagay yung pera mo? Okay? So 2% versus 12%. How much you get, how much they get. So alam niyo na yan kung sino ang kumuha at kumita. Your money work for you or others, no? So yan. So difference 6.2 million is equals to 31 years salary of someone who earns 200,000 pesos at least annually. Yan, meron tayong tinatawag na general concept of investment 1 and 2 and winning investment strategy para sa ating mga higher series of training. Yan, okay. So number 2, know how money market works, no? Know the investment instrument that can help you get the higher ROR of your money. Outpace yung inflation, harness the power of tax advantage, win the money game, no? Know the right financial strategy, the best diversification strategy that can help you build wealth, at the same time provide adequate protection for your family and for your health and for your asset as well. So what are the some realistic investment options that can beat inflations and taxes? Una, Kaiser. Yan, di ba? We have investment with healthcare and insurance. This is a 3-in-1 product. We also have most 18 with a PDF or your premium deposit fund. You investment with insurance, so it is 2-in-1. We also have stocks trading, direct investment in stocks, mutual funds in direct investment in stocks, no? With zero load for IMG members po yan. Affordable and also tax-free. Diba? Know the risk when you invest in stock market and mutual funds. No, I'm not saying na ora-orata maglagay ka na ng investment. Of course, you have to learn about it first and you will know what's the risk about it. Okay? So, yan po one of our benefits, no, dito sa atin sa IMG. Yan po, magkaroon tayo ng investment through mutual fund. We have free seminars. We have also zero entry fee. Diba? Ano na po natin yan? Disclaimer lang po, no? IMG does not sell mutual funds. All mutual funds are sold by Ramp River Financials. Okay, take note po yan. No? Meron din tayo MyTrade. You can do direct access for our online trading platform. No? Access to stocks online trading platform. So, mutual fund and stock markets both invest in stocks listed and traded on. Ayan po yung mga companies na yan. No? Diba? Sabi nga rito, if you can't beat them, join them. Kaya mo ba magtayo ng sarili mong Jollibee? O gusto mo magkaroon ng ibang pangalan, di ba? Eh, ano na po yan, established na po si Jollibee, hindi na po yan basta-basta matutumba. Kung hindi mo magagawa yan, then join them. Di ba? Buy ka na ng shares sa kanila. A new industry before investing is only a rich man's game. Tama? Pag sinabi mag-invest ka, pang mayaman lang daw yan. Pero ngayon, hindi. This is for everyone already. And of course, thank you so much to IMG, no, kagaya ko, no. I am always very thankful, no, kasi bakit? I was able to save money, I was able to buy the shares dun sa mga companies na pinakita natin, and we started already investing our money for our future. Today, investing is everyone's reality. We all need to know the right investment instrument that can help us outpace inflation and win the money game, no? Yan, napaka-importante yun po na malaman natin what are the right information para at least hindi tayo basta-basta malulugi. Okay? Win the money game. So, when making financial decisions, you may ask these questions. Diba? Can it potentially grow to achieve my goal? Does it have guaranteed and never go negative? Does it have healthcare? Does it have insurance? So these are the questions dapat when we talk about money, no? So dito po sa atin, win the money game, the best diversification strategy. Meron tayo mga different, no, investment vehicle kung saan mas mapapadali natin yung pag-build natin ng solid financial foundation. Yan, yung Kaiser natin, no? Tingnan natin ngayon yung mga questions kanina. Ang Kaiser ba, may growth ba? Yes. Guaranteed ba? Never go negative? Yes. May healthcare? Yes. May protection? Yes. Wow, check na check, di ba? So, ang PDF Most 80 naman po, may growth ba? Yes. Guaranteed din ba siya? Yes. May healthcare? Wala. Pero, may protection. Okay? So, stocks trading, may growth? Yes. Guaranteed? Wala. Healthcare? Wala. Protection? Wala. Mutual fund, may growth yan? Walang guaranteed, walang healthcare, walang protection. But if we could have all this, definitely you answer all those questions, diba? Lahat yan meron. The Kaiser LTC and PDF Most 18 will offset the risk in stock market and mutual fund investment. At least, nahahatak siya doon, diba? So yan, no? Meron tayong tinatawag na the right strategy, the right solution. Of course, yung ating solid financial foundation. Yan, pag sinabing Kaiser, investment, meron tayo niyan. Pag sinabing healthcare protection, Kaiser. Most 18 para sa life insurance, increase cash flow, manage natin yung debt natin, increase natin yung cash flow natin with emergency fund, and we do IMG business, and increase our cash flow. Access to IMG's complete solution, we have the triple E na tinatawag, which is the education, execution, and entrepreneurship. Okay, so we also have our higher series of training for that. Yan po, no? So, nasolve na natin yung ating solid financial foundation. Wow, no? Congratulations to everyone. Pero alam ba natin kung paano natin gagawin ito? Ano yung kasunod na gagawin natin? Then let's do it na po. No? Huwag na natin patagalin pa yan. Financial education is useless without financial execution. Wala po tayong mabibuild na financial foundation kung puro knowledge lang po tayo. Knowing what to do is not enough. We still need to do something on it. No one ever became wealthy by just learning, no? Of course, they act on it. Diba? So you cannot build a solid financial foundation without financial products as well. You need financial products to be wealthy and stay wealthy. Diba? Ano yun? Ganun-ganun lang yun. Umaman ka na. So dapat meron po yan. Dapat maintindihan natin yung mga products na yan. And of course, how it works. Diba? Yan. kailangan. So yan po, no, execution. Dati, kung isipin natin yung traditional industry, kung ikaw yan at gusto mo magkaroon ng healthcare, life insurance, investment, of course, what you have to do, you have to look for the agents, the products, the companies, and compare everything. No, until such time, napagod ka na. Parang na, feeling mo wala ka nang naumpisahan. Diba? Wala kang na-execute. Do they offer the products to you for your interest? O baka naman sa pang-sariling interest lang nila yan. Okay? Dito sa IMG, you will have the access to major providers like Kaiser, Manila Bankers, no, sa life insurance natin, or sa investment natin, yung mga Phil Equity, sa Rambler, no, and even for real estate like SMBC, Ayala Land, with those biggest companies na meron tayo dito, no, hindi mo na kinakailangan pang pumunta sa agent. You can do it on your own because they give you access directly. One-stop shop. So control your future. The future is in your hands. If you want to be wealthy, of course, don't let others do it for you. You have to do it yourself. Remember, no one is responsible for your future but only you. How can they make you wealthy that they have difficulties in doing it for them as well? No? Parang sila nga namumroblema, paano ka pa niya matutulungan? Diba? Entrepreneurship. Yan, okay? So easy setup, sabi nga natin kanina. No, it is full-time or part-time. You can do it full-time or part-time. So most of us here, no, we're doing it part-time pa lang, lalo na kung mga trabaho. But we can do it also full-time. Powerful online platform. No, you can do it at the comfort of your home. No territorial boundaries, as I explained kanina. With vesting rights, hindi masasayang yung pinamana mo. System-driven po tayo, not personality-driven. Okay? And of course, purpose-driven business tayo. Business with benefits, with 62 benefits and counting, no, meron tayo lahat niyan. Okay? So, benefits of being an IMG member, you can watch all of this. Ayan, okay? So, I hope everybody can hear it.
The International Marketing Group, a global financial education enterprise, strategically partnered with the world's leading providers of financial products and services, introduces its top benefits offered exclusively to its growing list of members. Free exclusive financial education through the financial ebook, The Secret to Saving and Building Your Future. Free exclusive financial e-workbook, The Financial Foundation Educational Program. Make money work for you through financial e-workshops. Increase your cash flow and debt management. Learn to build a strong financial foundation, proper protection. Know how to build your wealth and gathered assets. Get to know your plans for retirement and wealth preservation, and learn to build your business in the financial industry. Free financial checkup to diagnose your financial health. Exclusive course fee discount for the Associate Financial Planner Certification Program in partnership with Registered Financial Planner. Reap tons of free gifts from IMG's partner companies. Up to 300,000 pesos of personal accident insurance from Manila Bankers Life Insurance Corporation. Exclusive access to Fidelity Life, a mutual benefit association exclusive for members with 50,000 life insurance coverage and 24/7 memorial concierge services. Exclusive free gifts with Vision Care, now more accessible to all members anywhere in the world. Get your free IMG and Kaiser frames through the IMG portal. Free unlimited consultation and discounted medical services for members and their immediate family members through IMG's exclusive partnership with Kaiser Medical Center. Become an automatic mutual fund investor through the IMG Solvivo Strategic Growth Fund in partnership with Rapper Financials. Get exclusive access to IMG's partner industries. Exclusive access to the best long-term, short-term, and senior care services from Kaiser International Health Group Incorporated. Access to the multiple option super term, life insurance products, income replacement assurance, and Everest Memorial Solution designed by the country's top insurance provider, Manila Bankers Life. Free investment seminars. Invest in mutual funds at 0% entry fees exclusively to IMG members. Access to stocks online trading platform, MyTrade. Access to special rates from Palawan Pawn Shop. Increase your savings with these exclusive discounts. Save your money on your car, fire, travel, personal accident insurances through Vault Assurance, an IMG brand. Exclusive member savings on real estate purchases. Special discounts on memorial lots and interment packages. Exclusive member discounts on special courses to keep you abreast of the evolving technology and ever-changing industry. Convenience and peace of mind with our 24/7 memorial concierge service, providing assistance to help the family arrange the best but most reasonable funeral for their loved one. Protect your assets by creating your own corporation through asset preservation service. Combine huge savings and personalized assistance to enjoy a hassle-free car purchase experience with our exclusive IMG Auto Program. Be in the financial industry. Become debt-free, help families achieve financial success, and get the income you want from your own business in the elite financial industry. Experience the world's wonders on your vacations, cruises, and conventions through IMG's Travel Rewards Program. Qualify for the exclusive and world-class IMG Recognition Awards. Free HMO coverage for marketing directors, senior marketing directors, and executives. Get the member support you need. The most powerful members portal available anytime, anywhere. Domini2, the best digital marketing platform for IMG members. Know the latest IMG updates, news, runs, and reminders through the exclusive newsletters and emails. Nura Cash e-wallet facility for IMG international transactions. It allows members to conveniently receive commissions and IMG payments, transfer funds, pay bills through the kiosk, and request check for pickup at IMG office. It's accessible anytime, anywhere. International members exclusive benefits. Exclusive money platform. Exclusive events. Exclusive runs and contests. Worldwide protection for international members. Accidental death benefit worth 500,000 pesos. Burial benefit worth 100,000 pesos. Accidental medical reimbursement benefit worth 100,000 pesos. Benefit that protects you from acts of terrorism worth 600,000 pesos. Benefit that protects you from unprovoked murder and assault worth 600,000 pesos. Accidental disablement benefit worth 500,000 pesos with additional feature of repatriation service. Accidental disablement benefit worth 500,000 pesos. The possibilities awaits you here in IMG.
Okay, no, na napakaba ng video natin kasi napakaraming benefits na meron tayo. And of course, there's more to come po sa ating mga benefits. Ayan. So, with all of this, how can you go wrong in joining IMG? Magkakamali pa ba tayo with all that benefits? So, many benefits right now. Total of 62 benefits na po in counting. So, sa tingin po ba natin, napaka-expensive niyan? No? Of course not. Okay, so dito po, no, we can have our solid financial foundation, yung cash flow quadrant by Kiyosaki, yung access to IMG's complete solutions, yung ating tinatawag na triple E, no? So start to earn additional income, no? Ang tawag po natin diyan ay Jose, no? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Join, you own, and you share, and of course you earn. Kung magjo-join po kayo rito, how much do you need to pay? So it's 5,500 po kung sa Pilipinas po tayo. Okay, or PH code na tinatawag. Pero kung international naman po tayo, about 10,000 pesos po yan. Meron lang tayong yearly renewal na 1,500 pesos po. So, small amount kung titingnan natin, pero it's a big help and masosolve yung mga problems natin pagdating sa pera. No? Number two, own. You have to start, save, invest, and build solid financial foundation with Kaiser 3-in-1. Yan, no? You can have your investment, you can have your own life insurance, and you also have healthcare protection. Number 3, share, earn. Increase cash flow, no? Don't sell. Share what you do and what you have, no? Hindi naman natin kailangan magbenta rito. We just have to share the same opportunity, and for sure, they will also need it. Lahat po tayo kailangan po natin yan. You earn when they do what you do. Save, invest, and build solid financial foundation through in our Kaiser, no, or Manila Bankers, no, in our real estate as well. Increase our cash flow. And you become a business owner as well. So be an investor po ng mutual, by having mutual funds, no, sa Solde po, magkaroon ng Kaiser, ng Manila Bank, Manila Bankers po, no, you have to invest. And yan yung access natin ngayon. Okay, so Wealth Academy Training Program, a comprehensive learning program to give every member the best chance to succeed. So this is an additional to the IMG educational platform. Napakarami pong pwede nating matutunan. Okay, kaya meron tayong mga education, no? So there's so many discounts and amounts that we can also save by having a membership here. So when is the best time to start, do you think? Of course, yesterday, kaya lang dumaan na yan eh. Lalo na kung hindi ka na nag-member kahapon. Pero meron naman tayong second best, which is now. Today, it's very important. So habang mababa pa po ang ating PSEI sa mutual funds prices, pandemic-proof business din po siya. Kahit na pandemic ngayon, we can be able to do our business. Investment need time to grow. Pero ano yung pinaka-worst dyan? Tomorrow, no? Kasi procrastination is one of the main causes of failure. It is the manifestation of lack of discipline. Okay, so we have to start now. Whether you are ready or not, the details of your path will only be clearer once you start acting, no? We grow older every day, and even our children, our parents, no? What if 10 years from now, no, nagising ka na lang and you realize na wala ka palang na-accomplish, wala ka na-start, na kapoprocrastinate mo? A journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step, sabi po yan ng sikat na si Lao Tzu. Okay, si Lao Tzu. Raymond Lao Chinko. Joke lang yan, okay? Para gising pa tayo. Pero si Lao Chu po yan. Napag-aaralan natin yan during our school days, okay? All great things and ventures have starting point. Yan, sabi po ni Bill Gates, if you're born poor, it's not your mistake. But if you die poor, then it's already your mistakes, no? Financial independence is not only a dream. It is a decision or a choice to make, okay? So yan po, no, this is one of our book that we're using for our global campaign, The Secret to Saving and Building Your Future. So get a copy of your SSBYF book. So for details, see the person who invited you to help you get started and to guide you every step of the way. Okay, so thank you so much to everyone na nananatili sa ating presentation for tonight, and I'm sure and I believe na marami tayong natutunan for today. So if you have any questions, you can just ask those people who invited you para mas maunawaan pa po natin. Thank you so much. This is Christopher Salvador once again. To God be all the glory.